last example of morphing is a manual morphing. What we got here is a blade. Let me turn the notes off. And you see here a blade. It's a hollow one. So there's a cooling channel inside of it, and we can here take a look and scroll through the model. Now there's already a mesh attached to this part. So this part is meshed. There's a 3D mesh on it. And scenario what we had here is that somebody wanted to simulate us this part with a modified mesh to represent a damage, and they actually had the damaged part. They scanned it, they provided me the file which I imported of the zone where we got some damage. So if I'm zoom in on this zone, you see here the green mesh. This is from a scan, and you see here sort of degeneration inside of the face. So we could go in modeling, try to recreate all that, but it's really quite simple in the CAE environment to modify my mesh to follow this new face. But we don't have a face yet, so what we are going to do is, first of all, on this mesh, we're going to create a new polygon face from mesh. So I got the face from mesh option. Let me select the lasso option, and we're just going to drag around our zone to create a polygon. Okay, and that polygon will be used later on for morphing. So I can turn off now my damaged scan, and you see here the polygon with this zone in it. So next I want to morph nodes around this damage to this zone from my existing mesh. So let's turn on my existing 3D mesh of the blade, and I want to select those nodes. So one of the things you can do is just create a new group of related nodes. Related to what? Not to the mesh, etc. But if I turn on my geometry again, so my solid geometry, I can select now my face. So here I got now all the nodes selected on that face. So say nodes on face 3D model. Okay, so I can do now a show only of my nodes, and let me also visualize the damage zone I got. So now I'm going to select the nodes. I'm going to make a new group of nodes, not related nodes, but just nodes inside of my selection. So let me, to be sure that I only have nodes, my selection filter. So I just drag here around this, and now I got all the nodes that I want, for example, also at those. Okay, so I got a group of nodes, and we're going to merge those nodes to the new face. So let's call it nodes to morph. So not merge, I meant before morphing, obviously. Okay, so I got my groups to morph. I got my damaged face. So let me turn on my 3D mesh again. So the morphing again, we got our automatic morph from previous example, association, also disassociation, which we also already showed. And now we're going to do a manual morph. A manual morph of what? Of elements. So all those elements here that I select now, they are welcome to move. So I say to the software, well, you can play around with the elements I just selected to reposition them. So they can be recalculated. I'm going to now say I'm going to move nodes to a face. So which nodes am I going to select? I'm going to say nodes in a group. Let's wait for a second. Okay, and I'm going to select my nodes to morph. So those nodes can change, and they have to move to this face. And I want just to move them to the nearest position. Can create this mapping. And now I did my definition. I can define other definitions, but this is okay. And let us just accept this. And now those nodes are morphed to the new position, and the elements I selected can move with them. So here you now see, if I turn this off, my 3D solid mesh with now also the damage included. So in the model display, let me say that I don't want to show my nodes independently anymore. But what I now can say is, show me the nodes to morph, show only. And here you now see the elements attached to the nodes. You clearly see that there's a zone, a compression zone here, but not at the back end, because here the nodes were still on the face and they had to stay the same. Nothing will happen there. So if I do a few times show adjacent, just a rectangle in my case now, apply last time, okay, and you see here quite nicely this compression, and here a face like expected. And if I would take a look at the section again, we can move here, and if we zoom in again, here you see the compression of my damage, and here it's straight. Okay, so this can be seen here.